Okay, so, all right, you can reset your timer, Pembles. All right, sweet. All right, on three. Are you guys ready?
Yes.
All right.
Yes.
One, two, three. Good luck.
Geo.
You like racers?
Oh, shoot. And they're off. Wait, I gotta put them in the channels. Pembles, one and two. There we go.
Very nice.
All right, now I can edit the commentate.
No worries.
Prof Polly, I'm commentating a prof.
It's your boy.
It's your boy, Prof Polly. Epic name.
Yo, I was out driving out, doing some door dashing,
Oh,
hitting up Nick,
nice.
doing some commentating with you.
Hell yeah.
Got this exciting Banjo-Kazooie race.
I just got back from duty, so I was like, I got a lot of sleep. I had like a nightmare. It was weird. I had a nightmare
Oh.
about like Diddy Kong Racing. It was hilarious.
What
Ravioli,
is the
ravioli. Give me the formioli. All right, so we have some All right.
no game audio?
Oh yeah, what am I doing? All right, I guess we'll do
God
Pixel Weezy
damn.
since he has the better PB.
All right.
There we go. Let me know if you guys can hear that. Can you guys hear that? Okay, sweet. We're good! Alright. See, what would we do without Asmi? Oh, wait, Asmi, can you change the title for us? I don't know if you could do that.
Title's good, yeah.
Okay, title's good. We Gucci. Gosh, Asmi's always one step ahead. He's basically a superhero. Little admin
Asmi's
for S-class superhero. He's like, ask me to be like that like superhero in the anime and be like, of you're already dead. What? Epic sauce.
amazing.
All right, let's see if one of these runners do oh my watch and let's see if one of these guys do bottle skip. Oh, is he gonna do it? Oh, he did it! Pixel Weezy did it! Alright, now it's Pembles' turn.
Yeah, I'm looking at stream. I'm looking at Discord now here. So,
Oh yeah. What's up, Trap? How you doing, buddy? Trap. Looking at your competition, I see.
just tricking.
Oh, okay. Pembles didn't get it. But he's going through like a champ still. Oh, turn Prof up a bit? Yeah, let me turn him up. That.
Yeah, I'm known to be quiet. I
All right,
apologize.
now I turned him up from 200% to or 100% to 200%. So you guys should be able to hear him way better now. Oh shit, Footy!
Telephone
Footy, how's the Super Bowl? Who's winning? I need to know. And he's in. Yo, 3 minutes into Mumbles Mountain is pretty good, actually. Not bad. I usually get in like 258.
Yeah. Definitely a good time to get in there for a Pixel Weezy, for
Yo, A Healy! How you doing? Put him at any percent. Got him. I fucking love Crosby's jokes.
I've just got some good jokes. I
Oh, it
agree.
looks like Pixel Weezy's doing the advanced route, going to Ticker's Tower early. I see. Guess it's not
It's
really
a
it.
little bit faster, but it's not significantly faster.
Yeah, I know some people do it differently. Like they go to the hut first. Oh shoot.
Oh my
That
gosh, the double tap.
that's Dude, that ticker wasn't playing around. He's like, y'all runners always killing me. I'm gonna fight back today. Oh, that was dope. He literally came from the top or came from underneath just to kill that ticker. He's like, nope. Yo, what's up,
Well,
cooldown?
he's not full health, so he's gonna get an extra text box from bottles whenever he gets to a conga.
Oh
He doesn't
yeah,
get
that'll lose
one.
a little bit of time. True. I forgot what route Pixel Weezy does. I guess we'll find out. Alright, Pembles playing it safe. Doesn't want to make any mistakes. Understandable. So Pembles and Pixel only like about 13 minutes like apart. And with their times, like, anything could happen. Like, they could actually die, and Gobies with 95 notes or something. Like, what happened?
Yeah, honestly, most of the time, like, with these larger PBs, it's just, you know, it comes down to, like, a death or, like, you know,
yeah, exactly.
Using a vial. You know, these kind of bigger mistakes take, like, 10 minutes, you know, so.
Yeah, and usually, like, with a time, like, 2:30 and up, it's, like, they're at the time when they're still new, and, they're, like, they're not that consistent, so. That's fun about this, because even though they're, like, a little apart, anything can happen.
Oh, yeah.
And Pembles was, last race against Eagle, he was, like, he was on pretty good pace. He was pretty good.
Nice.
So even if, like, not playing for, like, 6 months or so, he still got it. Still got that banjo rhythm.
Yeah, I haven't been keeping up with the novice tournament up until now, so this is kind of my first experience with it. Oh, Pixwayzy getting hit by Kamaga there.
And as you guys know, Prof Polly is the one who commentated the grand finals. It was pretty epic sauce.
Yeah, we did, you know, just kind of.
He made the epic
band
opening.
Rich events.
I freaking love that opening. That opening was awesome.
It was pretty good. Pretty simple.
Maybe the theme will be like Groundhog's Day or something. Isn't that March? Boy, that's in jam.
That's like yesterday.
Oh, was it? Oh, wow. All
right. Or Friday, February. It's, you know, early February.
True. Maybe we'll get to the Easter Bunny or something in the at the end of the novice tournament. We'll take a picture of Nabnut, even though he's not a bunny. Oh shoot, okay. And Pixel's done with the conga phase. Now he's gonna go chill with Juju.
Yeah, Pixel's going pretty quick through the route here.
He's schmoovin'.
239.25 is you know, sub 240, it's a pretty decent PB, but he's got the movement, and honestly I wouldn't be surprised if we saw a PB from him today.
Yeah, for real. It's like really good. Like, this movement's like, it's like a sub 230 pace, honestly. But,
yeah, not quite sub 8 Mumbos, but, you know, around there, like 820, 830.
Exactly. A little bit more practice, he could definitely do it.
Oh, yeah.
I remember, like, when I first started, like, sub 250 was like, dude, you're crazy. I was like, oh my gosh. So I remember I was competing with, like, Dossie and, Pembles back then, I was like, man, pretty epic.
Yeah, Banjo is definitely one of the more challenging N64 speedruns. You know, comparing it directly to Xbox, you know, it's much easier on Xbox. Cause, you know, if you die, you can just, you know, retain your note total. And
yeah, and an N64, it's like super punishing. I see what you mean there.
Yeah, definitely in, like, a race setting, like, you know, we've seen with the BK League, you know, I would definitely honestly opt to play on the Xbox version, just if it means, you know, when
exactly.
I die, I get to retain my note total.
Yeah, for real. No punishing things there. More runs, save time in real life. It's a perfect speed run. Oh, yeah,
misses the Ninja skip there.
Apparently the enemies are more aggressive on Xbox. Wait, really? I didn't know that. Do they just like transform into, like a bigger monster? Or do they just run at you faster? I mean, I guess I could see them going faster, cause like, you know, there's no lag, so it looks like they're going faster, more aggressive, you know? Cause there's no lag on Xbox, right?
It's definitely less lag, I know that much. You know,
okay.
Loading zones.
Trip loves it.
Wait, so Pembles he's on emulator and not Xbox, right?
Yeah, he's on emulator. Which
okay.
is a little tough for clips, I think. Because I think yeah. clips are harder on emu.
It's interesting. I could have sworn he played on N64 before. I don't know what happened. But...
Yeah. I forget what happened too. But speaking of like lag and everything else, I got like a new retro tank. It's really good because like it reduces like your input delay, so it's or like it makes it perfect, I guess. So it's so like awesome. If you have like a smart TV, because if you have a smart TV, you are gonna have a little bit of input delay. Pretty useful.
Yeah, it's definitely a necessity because you know it's not like we build CRTs anymore, so
true.
Gotta have some way to convert it to a modern display.
Yeah, not only that, also like. I guess it doesn't just fix the input delay, it also fixes your whole picture of the game as well. It's crazy, because I was in Toxic Waste in Banjo-Tooie and I could actually see the pipe. Because usually you can't really see it if you're on a smart TV or something. Clean water. Clean water on Emu is hot, right? Is it clean water, though?
Yeah, I mean, I wonder how it compared to just like Xbox visuals. Might be kind of similar. I don't know.
They do like a little. They do look. Oh, never mind. I thought Pimbles was on Xbox for some reason. I was like, yeah, that enemy does look more aggressive.
Oh, I mean.
Oh, yeah, like, I thought clean.
they do just kind of look similar, like Xbox and emulator. I don't know why.
Yeah, exactly.
Just like that higher resolution.
Maybe it's on a like computer, not like an old N64. Could be the reason. I'm not sure. The world may never know.
It is a mystery.
And we're in the most comforting casual level, but the most run ruining level for speedruns. Good old TTC. I guess TTC isn't that bad. Personally, I just hate the flying section, or the last flying section.
It's challenging, it's not too tough, you know, it's where you learn to fly.
True. I guess I'd rather have it early in the game, or early in the speedrun, rather than, like, late.
Yeah.
If only they put Rusty Bucket Bay, like, third level.
I guess, you know, it's not, like, super punishing, you know? Like, if you land during the flying sections, you know, that's where it's hard, but...
Yeah.
It's not the worst level.
Yeah, that's true. Alright, let's see if he gets this note first try. Oh, he does a 7-flap strat. Ooh, he still makes
it. Got it.
Nice. It's really pog when you don't hit the ceiling. There.
Yeah. Single flap, yeah.
Because if you do hit the ceiling, you'll have to flap again, because you won't make it.
Yeah, Pixel Weezy's playing pretty quick here, you know.
Yeah, I don't really see any, like, hesitation, nothing. Not playing it really that safe. Just going in.
Yeah, Pimbles is, just entering level as, Squeezie's getting knocked out of that lockup.
Exactly. Yo, what's up, Metropolis? We got a Weezy fan. Oh, shoot.
Let's go.
Buccaneers versus the Chiefs all over again. Right here. Metropolis has got his Weezy jersey shirt on. Over. Oh, let's see if he gets his alcove. Nice.
Very nice.
Very nice not to land there.
Ooh. Okay, he got stuck on the wall there.
Yeah, exactly. I was like, oh shoot. And Temple's diving back up. How Pimbles does on this flight section. I think one of the biggest things about the novice tournament that could be like a deciding factor is definitely Rusty Bucket Bay, because you know they're still novices, like having like I wouldn't say like having perfected like late game, but like it could be more easily, like, you could die, in a way.
Oh, yeah. I mean, honestly, just like my recent experiences with the BK League, you know, I lost to Vile 2 times in a row.
Oh, yeah.
And, you know, just, there's just a lot of things in BK that just cost you minutes at a time.
And you wouldn't think it cost you a lot of time. Oh, shoot, Snoopy! Thanks for the good luck. Silent protagonist is... I can't even see the last part. Oh, no! It's gone.
It's raiding with Party 3. Silent protagonist, thanks for the raid.
Yo! Thank you, protagonist. Hope you guys love this epic race that's going on between these two runners.
Yeah, right in the beginning of it.
This run DKC some stuff footy cost you 45 seconds. Oh, wait. I thought I said footy. Yeah, right. So, he does have a good point there. Oh, he hit the ceiling. He'll have to flap again. I think I did this strat, like, pretty much most of my time playing speedrun, or Banjo-Kazooie. Oh, and he got
it.
Nice.
I intentionally, like, stick up on the wall there, but, I kind of monitor my movement a little bit better.
Yeah.
Than the Pebbles does.
And I actually learned just recently that I, like, how to not hit the wall, and I'm like, oh, shoot, okay. This is more fun, or more better, because I know you could accidentally, like, not go low enough, or high enough, where you'll, like, just barely get, like, caught on the chest. But, like,
you just gotta, you gotta peak bomb... And you pick up the note on the way up, and then beat bomb into the chest. And then
oh yeah, that's like the advanced one, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, that's scary. I think I tried that my first run. Didn't go too well.
if you're looking for a reset point at the 10-minute mark, that's the way to go.
Yeah. Did you only recently learn to not hit the wall? Yeah, I actually did. I've been hitting the ceiling forever.
Yeah.
Thunder found that? Not surprised, man. That guy's a monster.
Yeah, Thunderful, he definitely popularized it.
Oh, wait. Okay. I didn't even see where he did the third. Oh, he landed. That's okay.
Yo, DD Lux.
DD Lux, what's up? It's my rival in the TUI tournament. Are you excited about your match, DD, against SHM? Alright, let's see if Pembles lands or not. Dude, it really is.
He's got an interesting approach. He's going beat.
No way, DD. DD's gonna win.
Looks like he's got it.
Oh no, he missed the bird, George Chencho! I almost said purple. I don't know what colors are anymore. I promise I'm not colorblind. Oh, jeez. Aren't these two using different versions? So it's still N64. Pixel's on actual N64, and Pembles is on emulator. Have I ever talked in a normal voice? Yeah, I'm doing it right now. You thought I had a different voice? Psych. Yeah, what a silly question, Slippy boy. More like silly boy. Yeah, both on... Oh, you meant... Okay, NTSC versus PAL. Yeah, they should both be on NTSC. I almost said PTSC.
Pixel Weezy has a pretty decent DTC split here. Making
yeah.
Your same house on now. You know?
19 really isn't that bad for a 239, honestly.
Yeah, like sub 20. You know, like if you can get sub 30 clankers early on, you know, that's like pretty.
Especially when you fail like nipper skip. Oh, that was close. I thought he was gonna die there.
Yeah.
I assume Pembles is immune. Yeah, he'll be out. He's on NTSC. I think he did run PAL. Maybe that's the reason he doesn't do N64, because he had a PAL cartridge and he just wanted to do NTSC, which is understandable.
You know, it was interesting. For a time, Pal was faster for Banjo-Kazooie. There was in like the Clickwalk Wood lobby, we found like a clip out for the B, like before we found the 765 note door clip.
Yeah, and then like everyone was like telling Stib to run it, right? They're like, run on Pal. And then,
just import, a PAL CRT and a PAL N64 and a PAL.
Yeah, I was.
And also, like, in Furnace Fun, learn, like, German or French.
I definitely would have done that.
To answer the questions, right? Like.
Exactly. Isn't PAL, like faster frame rate wise or something?
So. NTSC runs at 30 frames a second optimally, mm-hmm. and PAL, I think it's like 24?
Oh, yeah, so it's 20, actually yeah, slower it's kind 25. Of on PAL.
Yeah, so, oh. right, so it runs at a lower frame rate, like, completely all the time.
That is pretty funny how that's, like, slower than, or how it was faster, because of the B clip that they found.
Right, yeah, just because of, like, the one clip.
And now they found a new clip, which probably saved a whole lot of time.
Yeah. Yeah, you might be familiar with, like, the PAL backflip in Spiral Mountain. Like, in PAL, they have to, like, walk, like, completely past.
Oh my gosh, dude, that camera angle was so scary that Pixel Weezy was doing. I thought he was gonna fall for sure. But yeah, it's pretty crazy. In this game, at least, physics movements are sped up a little bit to compensate for the lower frame rate. Yeah, okay. Alright, so hopefully we don't have any runners drowning here. Because, you know, as a kid, I drowned quite a lot in this part of the level.
Yeah, my friends down the street, they couldn't get past this third level here. They're just like, oh, I don't like Banjo-Kazooie. I can't get past Clanker's Cavern.
Yeah. For real.
Like, and that was it. That was their experience. They're like, I can't raise Clanker.
This in Rusty Bucket Bay was like one of the scariest things. So I would like avoid that part of like Rusty Bucket Bay for a while, and just be like, yeah. I could probably get beat the game without those jiggies and notes. Only I knew how to do dog skip back. It was rough. Stole the joke from Asmi. He didn't copyright it. Got him.
Alright, Pembles is chilling at 12 feathers here. As he's rounding up the end of TTC. Which is, still going. So, like, it's kind of a low number of feathers.
Dude, Oh, that sucks, because, like, he was just about to, like, leave the ledge, and then, like, he barely, like, his... Banjo's pinky toe touched the ledge and bam, fell. That's unfortunate.
Barely, yeah.
Pal would be fastest for a TAS. Really? How would that be possible? Because you can do 2E style big clips on Pal. Oh, okay, makes sense. We should have someone Taz that. As me. No, I'm just kidding. As me, the new Taz.
I don't know. I know GoGo is working on the Grunny's Revenge task, and I'm excited for that.
Oh yeah, I should like do that, like learn that speedrun as a meme. I've always I love Grunty's Revenge. It's been really fun, cause I like the collectathon kind of thing with like a GBA Advance kind of style game. Pretty yeah. cool. Yep, Chuzburger's gonna do it. JK. I don't.
Yeah, I know Hyper Resonance has been working on like an updated Banjo-Kazooie task, but you know, Ring Rush has been finding all sorts of bit clips and new strats like this, so.
Yeah, dude. He like found three actual, technically 8-Bit Beast found the MMM early, but wait, who found Clickbockwood early? Wasn't that 8-Bit Beast? 8-Bit Beast. 8-Bit Beast as well.
I think he might have found the majority of them in that moment.
8-bit biscuit. Can I have an 8-bit biscuit, please?
I feel like 8-Bit did all the Banjo-Kazooie stuff, and I think Ring Rush found the 2E stuff. I'm not positive. I don't want to...
I actually think Ring Rush did found Bubble Gloop Swamp early, though. Ooh. Ring Rush found the current setups for... Oh, yeah, because he found new setups for him. Yeah. 8-Bit Beast was the historical founder for the 8-Bit clips in for Banjo-Kazooie. He got awards and everything. Got a banjo medal. Everything. And then
3D print trophy.
And then in 1996 of January 14th, Ring Rush found new setups that helped the business go further. Look at that, Asby. Providing info for us. What a nice king. Drop this, my king. I love that. Oh, he got hit by the Chompa.
Oh, yeah, I'm not gonna talk from there. Yeah, Pembles had quite a bit of HP finishing off that sandcastle there.
Yeah.
He did the jiggy jig, had like two left over.
Okay. Oh, he got all the jiggies though, right? For Pembles?
Yeah.
Okay.
Everybody's
cool.
On track, but.
Yeah, we're not talking about anything,
Slip
Boy.
Like,
Slipboy, you didn't see anything. Let's Madagascar. Oh, let's see if he gets his backflip. He can do it. Oh, style. Oh, I love that. Backflip. I remember when I learned how to do the honeycomb backflip. Best thing of my life. And before I had an Everdrive, it was really tough to practice that.
Easy.
Wheezy on top of this game today. Yeah, easy. Pretty focused.
Yeah, it's a pretty decent run. See what time he gets out of Clankers. But his TTC time was pretty solid.
Oh yeah, wasn't that bad at all. 19 out, it's really good for his level. If you're really good at feather management too, you definitely like, you don't even have to refill feathers too at the end for Grunty, so maybe he can do that too. I remember when I was like a 230, 220 something, somebody was telling me like, yeah, you can definitely at the level where you can just use 7 feathers.
Right,
and,
yeah.
And even if you mess it up, like lose some feathers, like you miss a beak bomb, you can just easily get some feathers without, you know, having to just get that refill of feathers. Definitely saves a little bit of time.
Yeah, honestly, like, if you're pretty low on feathers, like, you can restock most of them on the plate. So.
Oh! He tried to get that jiggy. He almost got it, though.
It was a good attempt. It's interesting, you know, at, like, you know, with a PB of 240 to go for that strat in particular.
Exactly.
Because, like, if you get that strat, it saves, like, maybe, like, 5 seconds.
Yeah, he doesn't save that many, like, time. I see what you mean.
Yeah. But, like, you know, it's good to go for that sort of a thing, you know, for sure.
I think it's really cool and interesting, like, that people are also going for RBA, like, the RBA route, too, when starting out. Like, they're just going ham on all the strats.
I definitely support, like, honestly, RBA as a first Banjo-Kazooie 100% route, like, I would support that. It's not too challenging. Like, you can do the run every time as long as you don't accidentally open the 765 note door. Like, you know, suggesting somebody do, like, FP early as their first route, like, that's a bit of an ask.
Yeah.
And, you know, it can lead to problems, so.
I know, like, I mean, it's cool, like, going for all the strats and stuff, but, like, definitely think, like, you, like, it'd be almost a little bit better to go for, like, the no RBA route. Like, that, like, basically practices the movements. But it's always, like, you know, it's okay to try the cool strats now. I guess it has its pros and cons, you know? You have, like...
I guess I just feel like, you know, if you're going to learn the route for every level, like, you know, as well just, like, learn the small bead movement as well.
Oh, yeah.
That's...
RRBA got really easy for me once I, like, started practicing beat movement and stuff. So much time I saved just by learning that. Taking, like, an hour of my time.
Could always just do no FFM.
Right.
Yeah.
Get a sub to 10 if it. No FFM. Get a sub 2 now. All the strats.
Yeah.
Asmi, when's no FFM again?
Right, we saw Pembles getting some extra bubbles as he was raising Flanker here. Probably the best during a race setting.
Yeah. Playing it safe. I respect it. And Pixel Wheezy about to get these get this Jiggy first. Okay, he's going for the swag strat. Getting the Jiggy first, then the honeycomb. I'm a little weenie. I go for the honeycomb first.
It's not super tight, you know, but there is like a small difference.
Oh yeah.
As long as he pulls it off, it's alright.
I just always fear about getting stuck inside the pipe while getting the honeycomb, because I know if I just get the Jiggy, I won't get stuck.
Yeah.
Actually, technically, maybe the Jiggy would be safer, actually, technically. Because you won't get stuck at the Jiggy, then you just go for the honeycomb, and if you get stuck, there's no worries, because you already got it. Interesting. But there's a chance you could miss the honeycomb and get stuck.
I don't know, he didn't have that much time after he got the honeycomb.
True.
I know that when I go the other way, I've got a bunch of time, so.
Yeah, true. Versus straight. Never mind. Don't listen to me.
It's basically the same either way that you go, because you know, as soon as you dive, you've got the same amount of bubbles.
So. Yeah, that's true. Alright, so we're going into RNG world. No, I'm just kidding. We're going to Vile Land, so we'll see what happens there. Hopefully no one loses to Vile. Nobody's on Xbox here, so notes won't save. Feels like RNG with all the turtles and everything.
Yeah, the turtles aren't too bad, but it's definitely it's a small time loss.
Yeah, true.
Out of your control.
Good point. Good point.
We'll see if anybody opts for hut jumps.
I mean, it could also be RNG with the Vile mini game, because. Sometimes I've had runs where I did Vile, and like the Yumblies and Grumblies did not like me, and they just like surrounded Vile. Sometimes, like, I mean, you could win any Vile, but it could be like it could be harder, depending on what happens of where they're located.
Yeah, honestly, like,
you'll suck Falcon. You know,
when you go into Vile, like, you can either choose to stay on top of Vile and take all of the Yumblies or Grumblies that he's gonna eat, or you can be like, oh, I'm gonna stay on the other side and trying to like just get all the other ones that he's not getting faster.
But yeah, true. That's what I do. I always go where he's about to go to. That way I just steal all his stuff.
Yeah, definitely better to just like maintain control.
Mm-hmm. All right. Fucking blame. Nani?
Nani sore?
Nani doshito? Alright, Pumble's waiting patiently. Oh, wait. Oh, okay. Oh, he missed it. That's what happened. I was wondering what he was doing.
Definitely gotta get back up there for that.
Missing, yo, falling off that. Definitely a Monka S. I've done it a lot of times. Oh, I didn't get the pipe jump. Was going for it.
This is a pretty decent attempt.
Yeah. Something I wish the Tui, Tui, movement was into BK for that part. Is that, like, there's, like, a specific time you have to wait when you jump with Talonshot so you can flutter. But Tui, you can flutter anytime after you jump with Talonshot.
Right, yeah, you have to wait for Banjo to, like, get into his free fall animation.
Yeah. Let's see if he gets his leaf cycle.
Wow, he's super early for that one.
Holy crap, that was really early,
yeah.
Actually.
Yeah, right?
Dang. Is there a trick I don't know?
Maybe
not making the camera view that side of the map, so I don't know.
I think the biggest thing is just when you hit the first Croctus with the eggs as soon as you enter the level.
Oh, yeah. Dude, like, nobody's live. Do people care that much about the Super Bowl? Yeah. Yo, what's up, Brandino? How you doing? Granny! Okay.
Let's see, if I Google Super Bowl. Oh, the Buccaneers are... So it's 9 to 28. The Chiefs are at 9.
Did people get those back notes by the egg?
I
don't really see that. Oh, yeah, you probably did. There's a lot of notes for this beginning.
I think this note count is right.
Yeah.
It's 5 on the bridge, 3, 3, and then 5, and then...
Maybe he went for the notes first, and then went to, and hit the jiggy. It's a capo, but I feel like this is a part of it. This is the Super Bowl, JJ. Yo, what's up, Lanin? Oh shit, Lanin's got both jerseys on today. He's got both sides, Pembles and Pixel. Nice gold feather to his frog. Now, better question is, will he go for hut jumps?
He's not centering his camera.
Nice.
Interesting.
Oh,
yeah, I wasn't sure about the second.
Oh no, oh my gosh. This is so scary. He's got one health.
That's a fall clip there.
Okay. He's being safe. He's going for the health. Will he do it again? It's so tempting. Like I'll just be like,
I feel like, yeah, he's doing it.
Oh, he's gonna go for it! My boy! Oh, he misses it.
No.
At that point, I'm just gonna break the huts. If I miss it twice.
Yeah, the second hut jump is definitely the hardest. The third one is honestly not too hard.
Oh, you're talking about to the last hut?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, he missed the hut twice.
Yeah,
oh,
definitely
he's going for it again.
The second one is the hardest.
He's going for it again! Oh! Okay.
Look
Damn.
At the commitment.
I would have totally just failed and had the huts if I missed it twice. Hey, third time's a charm, right? Last
Shooting
one apparently.
At the crack just before you just do.
Yeah, last one's really easy. Do any of you guys go for the in between though, between the second and third one? That one's like the hardest by far. That one's super tough. He's going for this health. Okay. Alright. Pembles is getting close to the end. Safe with his camera angle. Like it.
Yeah, I guess so. Looks like he missed the honeycomb backflip, so he's gonna be getting these extra couple minutes. So.
Yeah. I saw it. He didn't go for honeycomb backflip. Just straight went down. Didn't trust himself. He's like, you know what? Nope. Not gonna risk that. I think I've had a run where I tried it. I did honeycomb backflip and I accidentally beak busted down, but I didn't get the honeycomb. It was so bad.
Yeah, I mean, definitely, like, if you know that, like, you're not gonna land this the hard strat, and you know, as long as you complete the task at hand and you fail fast, like, that can definitely be a big thing.
Yeah, true.
Rather than like wasting time trying to just line up and
do the setups
ultimately
and stuff.
Not doing it.
I agree with that, actually.
That's honestly, like, that's why I don't really do, like, in clankers, I don't really do, bolt jump, like, going to get the pipe over there. I don't really go for that, because, like, it just, it's like, if you get it, you save, like, 2 seconds, and if you lose, then you'll waste, like, 4 seconds.
Yeah, it's a lot of time to lose. Will Pixel go for, turtle skip, or... something. Tip tip skip.
I've never really figured that one out. You have to like be in a specific position. Yeah, so you have to rebound? Yeah, looks like he's got it actually.
Oh nah. You have to like You have to go into him like right after you skip the text, and then you'll like be in a specific spot on the right where he bounces you diagonal, and then you have to like keep pressing A and like holding the right diagonal direction. It's weird. I remember I learned it, it was pretty dope. Not that hard. Still a little inconsistent about it, though.
Down the colors. I'm just worried that, you know, if I do land it, then I'll just forget the turtle pattern.
Oh, yeah. True. That's actually happened to me before. Like, I did it, and I'm like, I got it! And I'm like, wait, what was the first one?
Yeah.
Dang, I wasn't paying attention.
Yeah, I gotta listen to the tip top again anyway.
Pembles make it. So close. Nice. Just made it. Had me scared there, Pembles. And just like that, he's out of clankers.
Wait, so can you see splits on you or something?
Yeah, I can see. I can see if they're how much they're ahead real quick.
Oh, okay.
And
yes, I was just gonna ask what Pembles' splits was like.
Pembles is about 4 minutes behind right now, and then Pixel is about like 35 seconds ahead.
Nice.
So.
Yeah. Right. It seemed like Pixel was doing pretty well.
Mm-hmm. All right.
We'll see. I believe in Pembles. If he holds out and gets like some decent mid game, end game.
Oh yeah, Pembles fell. A big time loss if you fall there.
Yeah.
Does Wheezy not normally write them down? Yo. I wish I had a big chat that told me the codes. Like, yo, it's a long story, you go, brother. They'd probably tell me, like, the way I don't want to remember it. I like to remember just, like, a different way, like, putting the, like, letters of the colors. Some of them, like, put numbers and stuff. I'm like, I don't know that. Nah, I probably wouldn't trust my chat, Snopey, actually. You're right.
Look, there's no light blue, there's only teal.
Should you? Definitely not. I guess it depends who's in my chat. Or who posts it. If someone like Asmi, then I'll probably trust Asmi. Unless he's eating pizza. Probably shouldn't trust Asmi after he eats pizza. Yo, what's up, Dingo? Dingo's here. I don't get why people use letters for turtles. It feels so inefficient. I mean, I used to do numbers, but then I would always get mixed up because the camera like changes all the time, like when you're looking at the turtles, and then it like switches back, so it kind of confused me. At least for like the letters, I know exactly what it is because their shells don't change. So it's just like color. And then I always thought it was weird because like I would like say pink and purple, like look purple, and I would call them both purple, but when someone said pink, and I'm like, oh, I just use PI for that. Yeah, I guess that is true. I used to do numbers, but I quickly switched back. What about you, Prof? What do you use? Do you use letters or numbers?
I mean, yeah, no, I use letters, and I kind of imagine it, like, visually, like, positionally based.
Okay.
So, yeah.
That's fair.
Kind of a combination of two. I never write it down, and, sometimes I mess up, like, the last one, but it's not the worst.
Subway just gave me an idea. What if I just, like, like a little circle. You know how like you have like those text boxes for when you're doing bit clips for lines? What if I had like just a little circle in the middle of my screen for Banjo-Kazooie? That way I could like see where I'm gonna like hit.
Yeah, there you go.
Genius. Doubles didn't get that last health, but it's okay. He's got plenty of health here. No biggie.
All I know is that I've lost to Vile more than I've lost to the turtles. Consistently throughout my experiences.
Oh, and he misses it. No leaf cycle from Tumbles. I guess technically you could get late leaf cycle. I mean, you don't need to put the U after P, because you know P will just be purple, and PI is just going to be pink. Oh yeah, Snoopy's got a point, you can use magenta.
Oh, there you go. Yeah, like, I opted to use teal, because it was better than light blue.
Oh, I use cyan for that one, I just put a C.
That works too.
Gosh, Snoopy of the genius idea.
Tumbles is getting knocked out by these frogs here. He's like 2 HP. He's getting the boots. He's getting hit. Tumbles, no. Oh, the double kill.
Oh! Dude, Snoopy, or freaking Tumbles never gives up, dude. Double kills, everything. Oh, he's going for the safe strat with the boots. Nice, nice.
Yeah. Nice.
He uses Z for pink? How? What does that mean? Zinc.
As long as you know.
Z for zinc. Maybe he does Z, it's like, he doesn't know what to do for like letters or something. He's just like, yeah, alright, that's the odd one out. I'll put Z. Or maybe zeal. Is that a color? I think zeal's a color. Oh, Rose. That kind of makes sense. Sorta. Alright, Pixel's on the third round. Is he gonna tough it up? Is he gonna beat up Vile?
Hey.
What's up, Prof?
Pixelweed's gonna get a nice PB here.
Yeah, I think he's got it. He's ahead, he's on pretty good pace. Gonna get sub 450.
Just the quality of gameplay that I'm seeing out of him. It looks nice.
Yeah. Yeah, Z is a good letter. Dragon Ball Z. I wonder why they put the Z for Dragon Ball Z.
I don't know. Because, you know, it's a Japanese show.
Yeah.
So, like, where'd the Z come from?
Z. Yeah, right? There's no Z in... Is yeah. there? Wait, is there Z in a Japanese alphabet? I should know this.
I don't think there's, like, a specific, like, Z. Like, it's a combination. Like, there's Zizazu, Zezo.
Yeah. Imagine. Maybe the Japanese are just like, Z, we don't use Z, that'd be cool. Dragon Mo, happy face.
Aspie's right. That's the best Japanese character. Like the kind of smiley face one.
Dragon Ball C. It's like Sailor Moon, but some random letters that at the end for each season. Oh, nice. And he ends it with one health. Nice Pixel.
Yo, sub 50 BGS.
Sub 50 is pretty pog.
It's a good time, you know, for like a knowledge tournament. It's a good time.
Yeah, definitely. And he's only in the like first stage. Just imagine if Pixel made it to the final stage. I'll be like at sub 48 in no time. Okay, Pimple's going for the hitting the switch early.
Yeah, so Pimple's doesn't do RBA at all. So does Pixelweezy do RBA?
Pixelweezy?
Did we go over this? I don't think we went over this.
I think he's doing RBA, judging from what just happened, because he didn't go for the little grunty
right.
jiggy.
Yeah.
So he'd probably do an RRBA, and then Pimbles is doing no RBA.
Pimbles can't find the angle.
Running BK. I love running BK. It's really cool. Sure, you die a lot. That sucks. Was racing Pimbles. I literally called Eagle Digit Chup like, oh yeah. Footy, when Footy was commenting, he kept calling Eagle a trap a million times. We're like, Footy, it's trap or it's Eagle. And he's like, oh shit. And he just continually called him trap. It's gonna be trap versus Eric's, Jake. Trap. What's up, prof?
No, I really like BK as a speedrun. It's, you know, it's not too long. It's, you know, it's longer than some games, you know, like compared to Mario 64, it's, you know.
Oh yeah, definitely.
Longer than that.
But it's like twice as short as Banjo-Tooie and stuff, like.
Yeah.
Way shorter than BK at least.
I guess like Ocarina of Time is longer.
I think so, 100%. It's like, well, I mean, it used to be like 5 hours for 100%, didn't it? Now it's like all these cheats they found, it's like 2 or 1 hour. I don't know. I haven't been keeping track of that.
Yeah, I'm really not super familiar with most Zelda games. So.
Don't mention OT around Schlag. Why? I don't really talk about OT that much. Except randos. You like randos.
Yeah, randos seem like fun.
Oh, just yeah, Pimbles having a hard time killing this Hagenfly. The flies just look at him. Yeah, Eagle's pretty good at. He's been getting pretty good at BK. He's pretty cool too. Pretty friendly. True. What you like to see is a friend, is a good attitude, you know? Alright, prof.
Absolutely.
Hell yeah. Oh. Ooh. Okay. Peak bus, rebound. I would have been really surprised if he was doing Yellow Star. Like, what?
Yeah. I don't even do Yellow Star.
Yeah, it's pretty difficult. I wanted to try it just for the memes. Like, I wasn't even going to do it in runs. But I was like, I want to try it and see if I can do it. And then I started doing it and getting really good at it. I'm like, I'm going to do it in runs.
And then you're going to get one run where you're like minus 20.
Yeah.
And you can fail it and you can cry.
It is really monk-ass when you miss it. I teared up a bit. Chiefs are sucking ass right now? Hell yes.
Oh.
I'm going for the Pirates, so that's what I like to see. What's the score right now, Footy?
Yeah, so they just went up to 31-9.
Oh, baby! Alright, there we go, Pirates.
I'm not really biased at all.
Yeah, I'm neither. I'm like, my team is Cardinals. I don't really care who wins. I'm just going for the Pirates because they look cool.
Other than the only thing I'll say is, looking at the logo this year, it, you know, it's Super Bowl 55, and the logo, they have like LV, and then they have like a trophy with like a football on top, like right in the middle, and it looks like LIV, and it's 55, not 54. No.
Oh, really?
I'm
yeah.
super distraught.
Yeah, but I did never bet against TB12 and Gronk, never. Oh, Tom Brady? Is that what you meant? Yeah. Tom Brady.
Tom Brady's been 10 Super Bowls.
Yeah, what the hell, man? Tom Brady's just too good. It's not fair. Must be cheating. Yeah. Damn, dude. Pixel getting these. Didn't get the first hit, but you know. This is good, too. At least you're not like Condi, who keeps trying to hit the snowman and lands like over and over again.
Shout outs to Condi.
Football, basketball, baseball. Football, basketball, baseball. Foosball. Nah, this is my football right here. Pixel Wheezy versus HP Pembles. The score is FP to BGS right now. Well, actually, that wouldn't make sense because they're doing different routes. Never mind.
Does Pembles go to Freezy Peak next? I think he does.
Nah, he'll be going to Gobi's Valley since he's doing no RBA.
Okay.
He'll be like that, and then he'll be doing, MMM.
Oh my god, that's just so much extra layer movement.
Yeah. I don't know why, I forget why that is. Like, why they do that? I forget. Maybe Asmi can explain to us why it switched for RRBA and no RBA. Dude, this broadcast I have, the commentators are talking about Vegemite. Dude, they're talking. Are they just like Australian commentators just commentating like the race maybe? Maybe that's why they're talking about Australia a lot. And no RB, you need to get the eye jiggy in the lair, which will only spawn after you finish the MMM. Oh, that's why. I actually never knew that.
Whoa.
That
makes
sense.
That's the caveat. That's the specific caveat.
Yeah, that makes sense, because you finish FP, and then you're already right next to the flight pad area to go fly into the jiggy. That makes sense.
Yeah.
I guess it would be technically be more lair movement if you did FP first and no RBA. Makes sense.
Thank you for this clarification, Asmi.
The Chuzz Burger. Vegemite? I've actually never had Vegemite. I've had their meat pies though. Their meat pies are so good. Wait, did Pixel do I don't know if he did the leg strat or not.
I think he did, yeah. I believe he thought.
So going for the hard strat, I like it. It's soy sauce, to be honest. That's what he says, I hate it. Wheezy does the leg strats? Boy, hell yeah. Alright, Pembles is going to Mumbo, about to transform into Vile, or not Vile. No, Pixel lost! Oh no! He didn't go through the gate, and then. Monka S. I've had that happen before. It's so Monka S when that happens.
Alright, Pembles getting a chance to catch up here.
Yeah, I think that's why you want to stay a little distance behind Boggy there, because he goes really slow up the slide anyway. So you don't have to be right next to him at the base of the slide. Wait, what were you saying, Prof?
Nothing in particular, just, Pixel is picking up a couple more collectibles on the way, making it a little easier to get the left leg as he does it as Banjo later.
Yeah, I saw that, that's pretty good, pretty smart. No, what I meant, Footy, is, he was, like, really close to Boggy when going up the slide, so it kind of pushed him out of the way, and he wasn't able to activate the flags. So, it's good to stay a teensy bit behind him, get that flag, and then you can just immediately catch up to him, because he moves pretty slow up the slide. What Prof just explained is, so he went to the left side to get that note.
Yeah, since he failed, yeah.
Yeah, since he failed, he might as well just got the note, so it would make it easier for Banjo doing the leg strap for that, for his next race.
Hopefully, Pembles doesn't lose to Vile here. I think he's got plenty of HP, So if he does lose, he could survive a chomp.
Yeah, I think he's got it. Left side at the end of the race. He got caught behind Broggy. Oh, yeah, I'm not sure. I don't know why he went to left side. Yeah, because he was really close and then, like, he was left side and got caught and then hit the left side of the flag or something. Didn't process. That's why I recommended staying a teensy bit behind him because you can easily catch him at the end anyway. What if you scooped a handful of Vegemite and shoved it in your mouth?
It sounds like a lot of Vegemite. Like, my understanding was that you put, like...
Just a little bit.
Just a little bit, yeah.
Yeah. I know that's thick soy sauce. A lot of it doesn't sound pretty good. Soy sauce is making me think of sushi for some reason. Sushi's so good.
So there's like three transformations left. Or no, I guess it's five. Do we think that we're gonna see a washing machine or a T-Rex? Should we start a prediction?
I'm down. Oh wait, can we do that? Oh wait, I don't even. Wait, if I'm.
Slash prediction.
Oh, dude, I could do. Well, I don't even know if I can do that prediction.
Are you mod?
Oh, I'm not a mod. That's right. Are you mod?
I can do it.
Oh shoot! We're gonna do some predictions. Or are we gonna do that for Pixel or Pembles or both?
Just in general, are we gonna see?
We're gonna see
a washing machine slash T-Rex.
Oh. So like that'd be three choices: no for both of them, and then washing machine or a T-Rex. I vote we're gonna see a washing machine. Ooh, actually that'd be four, maybe both. Four choices. Holly always saved the day.
30 minutes. Alright, you got 30 minutes. Well, we'll do 20.
Oh, you can only do two choices?
I mean, yes or no about washing machine slash T-Rex.
Oh, okay, yeah, that'd be better. I vote yes. Oh, baby, prediction time! Who's gonna get all the points?
You got 20 minutes to get it in.
Oh, baby.
Because I don't think we're going to see another transformation.
Yeah, because... Well, except Mad Monster Mansion. That'll be about 20 minutes. Actually, that'll be soon. Like, 10, 12 minutes. So, yeah, 15 minutes. Putting all my money.
You know, you don't have to bet. It's just there.
I'm putting there's a lot of no's.
Yeah, it's like a 5% chance.
I'ma steal all their points. Oh baby. You know, I like it that you guys are saying no. I'm betting $1,000.
These are some big channel points, you know. You could save them up for advertising a product.
Yeah, true.
So, you know, they're pretty valuable. Pixel Weezy getting the left leg strat. Hopefully he doesn't lose the second pocket race.
We need to come with more rewards, true. I'm all in on no. Oh, how many points did you have, Metropolis?
I honestly, like, no has a high probability. I don't know. But there's five transformations left, so.
I put 1.1k on yes. See? That's why it's gonna happen, Footy. See? You voted right. That's why it's gonna happen, because it hasn't been for a while. Shit ton of points, hell yeah.
You'll love to see it.
And
redistribution of well.
Pemble's about to finish. EGS. He didn't lose the vial, which is good.
Yeah, true.
Hagenfly doesn't want to be nice right now. There we go. And he's out.
It's like we're getting 105 flat.
Pebbles accidentally paused his timer. I don't know what happens after. I think it's okay, right? I think it's fine.
I saw it was stagnant, but I thought that was just when he was splitting. I don't know.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I think it's okay. We'll just think he's like 2 seconds supposed to be on Pixel or something.
Oh yeah, I do see it now. Like his timer is actually behind.
Yeah. Like positive for a second, but it's okay. We know.
It's fine.
Oh. Okay, never mind. It looked like he got out of, or he stayed in Talon Trot. Cause if you stay on Talon Trot, on the when going into the Grunty statue, you have to, oh, you'll take fall damage.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah, but if you get in there while just Banjo, like, you won't take fall damage.
Yeah, I usually tried to like flutter on my way down when I was doing that strat. That sounds like one of the cooler things, because it's so simple. It's just like, oh yeah, just jump off her arm.
Yeah, exactly.
It like feels accessible to just like the regular player.
Super. I actually didn't think about it until I watched speedruns, and I'm like, wow, I could have done that this whole time.
It's simple geometry.
Or just RBA and not do it at all. True. RBA is pretty. Cake.
I you know, it, like, it for whatever reason, it just wouldn't feel like a Banjo run if you didn't do a little bit of movement.
Exactly, you know? I agree. He's opening up the web to prepare for his flight whenever he needs it after MMM. Can washing machine ever happen when transferring back to Banjo? No, I think it's only when transforming into someone or into something.
Yeah.
I've transformed into a T-Rex before. Or I got T-Rex, not into a T-Rex, but I got the T-Rex. I think isn't T-Rex like 1 in a million chance or something?
I think it's like washing machine is like 5% chance and T-Rex is 1% chance.
So we got a 6% chance right now. damn, that's pretty unlucky if someone gets that 5%.
Well, but chance. we got two runs and we've got. Well, I guess it's only 5 chances total. But yeah. Mm-hmm.
6% times 4.
So it looks like Pembles, he just walked off the ledge there to just respawn by the door. But I think since he was at the puzzle, he respawned at the puzzle.
True, you got a good point there, Metropolis. Because there's 4 transformations left, right? Well, actually, you gotta account for both runners, so Pixels, so MMM.
Right, so Pembles hasn't done Freeze Easy Peak yet, so I think it's 5, right?
Yeah, so 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Yeah, a 5 transformation, so we could have a 30% chance. Actually, wait, we gotta think T-Rex too. So a 35% chance on me getting that.
I swear, you know, in Mad Monster Mansion, it's way more likely.
Yeah.
Washing
yeah, exactly. It's way more likely. Actually, that's not how math works, never mind. Because that's like me saying if there's like let me think. 10, 15, 16. That's like saying if there's 17 transformations left, that they would guarantee to Washi, but that's not true.
Right.
But it's definitely in between 35 and 6%. Gogo, how does that math work? Teach me.
There is some percent chance.
Hey, leave my English alone. It's perfect. It's 95% to the fifth power. What?
Does that make sense? That's right.
Is it? Why would it be 95%?
Because, so, I'm not a statistician, but,
say it's low odds. Definitely low odds.
No, I think Ogo's right. Is it 5% to the fifth, or is it 95%? Because we're looking for the 5%, not the 95%.
But wouldn't it be 6% because of T-Rex too?
True, yes. Yeah, add the T-Rex for sure. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's 6% to the 5th.
Yeah. I thought it was 5% or a failed confirmation.
Well, it depends if you're a doubter or a believer.
Yeah, 5% is only Washi, and 1% is T-Rex, so combine that, because it's a possibility of both transformations. So it's 6%, right?
Times 5. But, it's like 6, it's 5 specific instances of 6%, so.
Yeah, I think Espy's got a point. Could not be at 6%. I don't know, it's weird. Yeah, like you said, it's complicated. We'll just say it's like... in between 5% and 30%. So it's pretty much low odds.
175 problem for sure.
Connor only deals with electricity stuff. Does he? Wait, is Connor pretty good at math?
If you had Connor and Mumbo Token in the same room, there would definitely be a conversation about this math problem.
Oh, his job is statistics. Oh, yeah, that's true. Never mind. He told me he deals with some electric stuff. I guess that involves statistics. He does electric stuff. He's a lightning bender. Connor's a... he bends lightning. Or is Connor Zeus, or is he Azula?
Let's see how Pixelweezy tackles the graveyard here.
Okay, plays a save for the second grave.
Yeah, so he's using two gold feathers, and
oh,
looks like he knows the position.
Yep, oh, he's got to stand on like the right side of the circle. Oh.
Yeah. Yeah, you usually want to line up with the line, like on the wall there.
Oh! Oh, he doesn't get it. It was close, though.
Yeah, the Greybird is, like, a really tight section.
It is. I practiced it, like, so many times just so I can get it perfect. And I still don't get it really consistent. It's tough.
Yeah, it's definitely one of those, like, secret sections in Mansion that you can just lose 10 seconds on.
Yeah. Head count in Gobies is pretty scary. But I think it's you're pretty much safe. I think no RBA is, like, the safe part of eggs, because you don't have to really worry about eggs too much after Gobies, but Pixel's like situation's a little tight because he does our Gobies like after MMM. I remember back in my day, I went into the ammunition room. Times. Oh, Pixel does the Tumblr coding wonky. Oh, wait, never mind. Wait, what? Oh, yeah, cause, yeah. Wonky.
He might have made a mistake.
Yeah. Yeah, I forgot. It's all good.
Yeah, it's kind of a weird one now, though, because he's got a pop back over here.
Yeah, 14 eggs of Gobi. Let's see. Temples, I think he's got, he did one, and he already did the pyramid, so he's got, like, he only needs eggs for the last, no, he needs it for, the snake, too.
He can probably get the ones that he needs off of, the water pyramid.
Yeah, that's true.
And, like, inside of it.
Wait, 2 times 36. 8, oh, well, he's got enough. He's got, he only needs 11 eggs right now. Well, as long as he doesn't miss any. Is.
Right, yeah.
Oh, if Wheezy? Oh, yeah, definitely. Yeah, if Wheezy. Pebbles should be safe. I don't know how many eggs he has, though. We'll find out. Right now. About to go to the...
What are these things called? do they have a credit name?
Credit names?
Like the things on the wall here. I don't know if they have a name in the credit sequence.
Yeah, I forgot what it was. Egg eaters.
It's like, I swear, everything that has eyes has a name.
Oh, yeah, these guys for Pembles. Yeah. Egg eaters. This bowl is boring, by the way. Is it?
The ancient.
Guess I'm glad I left then. I'm gonna be right back. I'm gonna get some chips. Thinking about the Super Bowl makes me think of chips.
The score is tied. Quarter four, 6 minutes left. It's like the Buccaneers have it pretty solid. Which is surprising. They had a 14-5 record going into this compared to the Kansas City Chiefs 16-2. And the Buccaneers are just crushing it. 22-point lead. Can you believe it? Looks like Pembles is going around finishing up the ring sequence. And gonna be going for Grabba. You know, honestly, Gobi's Valley is one of the more difficult levels in this game. You know, there's a lot of factors like where the rings pop up, you know, whether or not you recoil off of Gobi's rock. You know, there's just a lot of factors, and it's a difficult level to route in a speedrun. So, you know, pretty much every route in Gobi's is viable. Looks like Pixel Wheezy is going to be trying to get this Jiggy on top of the organ in flight. So, does indeed grab it with his nose there.
And I'm back. And I got some Fritos.
Yo, Fritos?
Not just any Fritos. I got Flavor Twisted Honey Barbecue. That's right, folks. Yo. You can get Fritos Flavor Twisted Honey Barbecue for only 50% off if you go to the counter. And like $5, so $2.50. Thank you very much. That is Flavor Twisty Fritos. Or what? Fritos Twisty Flavored. What? Fritos Flavor Twist. Honey. Is it the tongue twister? Get it? Mmm. Very twisty. It's not an As Me class advertisement, but I did my best. I forgot what Asmi. I was watching one of Asmi's advertisements. It was funny as hell. It was like, are you? What did he do? It was like the fitness challenge one. That was hilarious. All right, so. Souls going in the top. Tower. He's pretty much almost done with MMM. Just has to transform into the pumpkin. I mean, or washing machine.
Yeah, Weezy's had a pretty decent run. He got the jiggy off the organ in flight. No problems with Moat Sand.
Yeah.
As long as he can make his way out without dying. Maybe he gets stocked up on some gold feathers.
That is true. Humbles isn't gonna land here. It's nice. You gotta come. Yo, I should, honestly, as me. I'm that's my homework. My next race, I'm gonna commentate.
I wish you would. Did we get another advertisement product?
Oh, wait, never mind.
Oh, I'm like clicking.
Oh, okay. Alright, next advertisement we get. Prof is gonna advertise it. Got it. Prof's already got something in mind, don't you, Prof?
I mean, I can come up with something. Pretty quick and nibble on my feet.
Hell yeah. You thought Pembles is going for Water Pyramid on Emu? Isn't it impossible on Emu?
It's definitely more challenging. I don't know. Hmm.
I know clips are really hard on Emu or something. It's more difficult. He was taking a weird trajectory. Gotcha.
Man, I swear Pixweezy's just like zooming. Pumpkin. Looks like he's hopping so fast.
Sorry, I was eating my chips. He really is zooming.
Yeah, right? He just looks like he's hopping so fast.
Like 122 out of MMM's not that bad. Pretty good. But I swear, like, the middle levels are definitely what, like, kind of dictates a little bit most of your time. Because. Like, they have a lot of just time in the levels. Like, I noticed I was getting, like, close to, like average runners with, like, the beginning levels. But definitely what matters most is, like, the middle levels and stuff. If you work on the middle levels, you'll save a lot of time.
For sure.
Axing Grace under pressure.
Under pressure! Breaks a building down, splits a family into bam bam bam. Under pressure.
Good song, by the way.
Going for a maze skip.
Pembles going for all the hard strats. I wonder if he's gonna do fall clip.
Right.
No!
A pretty decent time halfway through the run here.
Dude, he reset!
reset
me, to be honest. Anybody that's curious about why he reset there? It's faster to reset there to, like, just go straight to the next level. Rather than just travel with the pumpkin back to the lot, like, or transform back and stuff. And also, you get the little lair jiggy on the way here.
Yeah, Mumbo's like, hey, yo.
You're got you, Asmi. Was I correct, Asmi? Interesting. Oh, really? Okay. I could have sworn... I forgot who said it was a little faster. Someone said, like... it's faster because you have to, like, go back as the orange and transform back or something. But, yeah, that Jiggy would make sense. Okay. Makes a sense. Oh, no! Oh, I thought he was going to land on the slide. That was scary. But Humbles is like, oh, he's got 5 health. He's fine. He checked just in case. Dang. Pixel Weezy is going to say what's up to Pembles right now. Yo, Pembles, I'm here. Uh-oh. He's got 4 health. So if he's a little optimal here, he can make it. Oh, he's going for a health from his fly. Hopefully he doesn't get hit. Oh, nice route. That's what I do. Pixel's
yes,
doing
sir.
Right
he
now.
Didn't. He didn't gold feather into Gobies, but it looks like. Oh no.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, it's pretty quick in those notes for sure.
Mm-hmm. That's what I do. Like, I think he's doing. Yeah, he's doing the intermediate route. Is he doing the Moose Man Gobies? Dude, we gotta find a. I bet there's a Taz. Actually, wait, never mind. I guess you wouldn't need that Taz to poop in the Gobies nose because you just use Gobies Clip or Jinxie Clip. Gobies Clip. And we're going to Mad Monster Mansion with for Pembles.
The long swim.
Yeah. Might as well do MMM early.
On emulator?
Actually, yeah, I don't know if it's good on emulator.
So easy picking up every single egg inside of the temple here. Probably not gonna need all of them, but better safe.
Better safe than sorry, though. You never know. Could miss all of them. Or how many eggs does he have now?
He was sitting at 20.
Oh, he missed it, dude.
Yeah.
He was on it, and then he slid it off. That little hitbox could be a little messed up sometimes. Like, I think you have to, like, wait a little bit. Right?
Aim for the schnoz. He looks like he got it. Do any routes do the levels in the intended order?
No.
I mean, it depends. Yeah, basically depends on your definition of intended order.
Actually, doesn't... Oh, wait, no, FFM probably doesn't do the intended route anyway, or either.
I mean, no FFM visits a level twice. So.
Mm-hmm.
Perhaps that's the closest thing to intended order.
One's casual category, doing the casual way. I know it's slower, but why would it not be worth it? Is there like another like thing that makes it like kind of like risky?
Where?
Gogo was saying, is it not worth it to do, or it's not worth it to do FP, then go be Valley, then MMM in any scenario? Is it just solely because it's faster to do it like MMM in the middle?
I mean, it has to do with the lair movement, I would imagine.
Yeah.
Right, yeah. Gobi's Valley puzzle on the way to MMM.
Yeah, true. I guess, that would make sense to make Mad Monster Mansion in the middle. I don't know why I didn't think about that, like, when I was younger. Oh, that sucks. Pixel got out of flight there.
Yeah, that can happen sometimes. Definitely unfortunate when it happens.
Sometimes when you beat bomb through that ring, like, it sometimes doesn't process. I think it's like if you're too left of the ring or too right of the ring inside of it.
I think it has to do with, like, when your beat bomb is ending. Because, like, Banjo does, like, a dip at the end.
Yeah. That's true. And now it's time for the snake. That grabber was pretty smooth. He, like, dipped down real quickly and got it. Let's see what kind of pace they're on.
The good news is Pixel Weezy had enough eggs to get through Gobi's.
See, Pixel, oh no, Pixel's about like 23 seconds behind. And then Pembles is, can't really see, it's like about 6 minutes behind. Timer stopped. No.
Oh.
Yeah. Try and fix that. It's something.
Is that on your end or is that?
Oh yeah, it was my end because I was like trying to see what timer then I accidentally minus it.
No.
Yeah, it's still going on his stream. Like his like thing is going, but.
Trolling, when's the second monitor?
Right, for real. That would be awesome. I'll figure this out.
Where's Asmi when I need him?
Asmi, though. I mean, it should just be.
Oh,
deactivate and reactivate it, maybe?
Oh yeah, true. Do that. Oh, here it is.
Yeah, there's that one. Yeah, so just right click on it. Right click on it, and then properties, and then... like the actual timer.
Wait, are you sure? Oh, it's the time, that's why. Yeah.
No. So you click on the timer.
Oh, the timer? Oh, wait, this one.
Yeah, so that one, then right click on it.
There we go.
Yeah, there you go.
We did it! we did it! Thank God. I was like, how do I fix it?
The timer stopped. Invalid. Now sing it back up.
Oh, yeah. Well, Pembles is a little behind on the timer, or a little ahead, because Pembles accidentally paused this timer.
Briefly.
Yeah, he paused it for a second. But it's only for like a second, so I guess I should pause Pixels just a little bit. About right there, yeah, that's good. If it was like 2 seconds. When's the tourney? Songster, when's the tourney? It was all me.
Pixelweezy's he's rotating his camera. He's gonna have to deal with the rising statue. Oh, did he already get it?
I think so. Oh, I guess he did. He did already get it. Oh no, because remember he goes for the intermediate strat. So I think he got
a couple of them in flight.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, that's what happened. He got cactus ring. So he went for the cactus and did Jinxie early. That's why he did the snake later. Oh damn. It's always Monk S once you mess up the maze. And then saving it seconds later. You know it cool down. Don't ban me, please. All right. Let's see how Pembles does this grave section. Alright, he plays it safe, kills the grave.
My brain hurts.
Not many people know about that position, like behind the third one there, where you just line up on the line.
Yeah, I see when I was like studying how to do it, I was watching like Hag and people like go right in front of like the grave, like when walking there, like, and then you have like that perfect line. I wonder if behind would be good too.
I don't know, that section is tight just because it's like it's like minor AI manipulation, but like you know where they spawn and you know what they're gonna. So it's just mostly about execution.
True. All right, see if Pembles does tumble right. Oh, it's a little too outward right here. Doesn't go for the damage quick. And gosh, I can't speak English at all today.
Yeah, you can definitely just like slide through the grunty square there, take a hit of damage, and be quickly on the spot.
The maze in Armaly. Oh yeah, for Gobi. Yeah. I remember it was so hard for me to do the maze when I was a kid. I was like, gosh dang it. Like I would be so scared of dying. And then the music didn't help either because it was like na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na- to four more chances. Alright. Pixel Wheezy versus Engine Room. Who will win? Engine Room's definitely a scary one. I think one time I got
a lot of confidence in Pixel Wheezy here. I think he's gonna do it.
Yeah. Bet he's got it. Wait, where is it going?
Yeah, I don't know.
Oh, maybe he got mixed up. Or maybe he forgot a token? It's going to MMM.
I think this is just kind of like blind movement accidentally. He'll just gonna turn around and realize soon, if I had to guess.
Yeah, he's going to be like, wait, let's see when he realizes, when he gets the... he's going to open MMM for the second time. Oh, yep, he realizes. He's like, where am I going?
Oh, he's gonna drown. No, he's
oh, no! No! No, no, no,
But look at how high that water's raised.
Yeah. He's like, wait a second. This isn't right.
Well, just it's gonna damage his chances of PB, but, you know.
Yeah. Have a Super Bowl as me? As me having a Super Bowl. I would feel so mad if I like forgot the route and went to the MMM lobby. Like, man, dang it. No. That'd be pretty funny though, I'd probably laugh it off. Like, wow. Super Bowl is filled with nachos. Choice. What cheese dip do you guys, or not cheese dip, what kind of dip do you guys prefer for your chips?
I love guacamole.
Ooh, guacamole. It's pretty good. I like medium salsa sauce, like medium hot. It's pretty good. With some scoops chips, nachos.
My favorite thing in the world is like... One advice that I got when I was a Boy Scout was take a bag of Fritos with you when you go camping.
Yeah.
Because they're so oily that they literally start fires. Like you just light it.
Really?
Yeah, it's a great fire starter because it's so oily. And then if you don't need it as a fire starter, then you can just eat them because they're Fritos.
Hey, and it smells good when you burn them.
Yeah,
you know?
Right. But it's just so oily. Like, it's a good fire start.
Do not start campfires. Smokey the Bear would not approve of Fritos. No, I'm just kidding. Yo, Shakes! Okay, so, okay. What's up, Shake Bakes? Shake Delicious, Expialidocious. What's funny is that Reddit Super Bowl isn't about the Super Bowl, it's about the Super Bowl. Wait, oh, the superb owl?
That's funny.
Who's winning? It looks like Pixel Wheezy is in the lead here. Definitely has more jiggies and notes.
Yeah. I mean, he definitely lost a little time when going to lobby, but not enough time to where, like, the gap will get that, like, closed. I think Pixel would have to, like, die a bunch of times in, like, engine room for Tumbles to catch up.
Yeah. Because, I mean, like, basically, they're in the same position, except Pixweezy's done Freeze Easy Peak.
Mm-hmm. It's super battle, that's funny, though. Parch just won? Is it over? Hell yeah. Yeah, you guys know what that means. Aaron and me made a little wager. He said he's going to do, he's going to come back to BK and start grinding.
Whoa!
If the Chiefs lost,
I love to hear that.
Yep. Shouting him out. Super Bowl being about Al is like April Fool's joke that never ended. Oh jeez, I wonder what. Oh my gosh, this is pretty pretty scary for Pixel. He has to get this first try.
He's actually, 2 HP here. Yeah. It's
really scary.
The second one I'm way less concerned about, but it's hectic.
Yeah, you could get hit twice trying to. But yeah, second fan is easier. Okay, he's good. Ooh. He's good. So hopefully this guy over here doesn't hit him when he tries to get these four notes.
Yeah, it's a little semen gremlin. Oh, he wants to get out of Talentrot.
Oh,
he's in Talentrot.
Oh, he's trying to do it. Okay, yeah. Now he's gonna go for the easy clip. But it's still not working. Can you make
That's
this
a lot
timer?
Of time.
Oh, I would go back. God. I would totally go back and hit this button. Okay, he still makes it.
I was gonna say, like, if it got to 40, I'd go back. But like, ooh, yeah, he's got it.
I either
like,
go back
tight, though.
I either go back or I'm going straight for the Jiggy. Like after I get these notes, that is.
Looks like he's not getting the lifeboat token.
Yeah, okay, he's playing it safe. Good. He doesn't go for the Jinjo at first.
I agree. Wait, Pebbles didn't get a Washi, right?
Oh yeah, he didn't get Washi.
Okay.
So we got 3 more chances. Am I gonna lose all my points? I'm gonna lose all my points. Alright, yeah. I forgot the honeycomb box was there. It would have helped me a long time ago.
As long as you look out for the bees.
Exactly. He has the same alert as me. Which one? Is it the Jinjo one? Yo, I should do that Asmi says turn off alerts thing. I don't know how to do that.
You have to delete everything on Streamlabs or Streamlabs.
Oh, for real?
Yeah, like you can't really.
Oh, it's an account Gage made? Damn. Where's Gage when you need him? Same color too, orange. Yeah, I have the orange Jinjo alert too. Having a little trouble on this slide.
Honestly, during tourney races, if you get a follow alert, it's not that bad.
Yeah, it's not too bad.
Like, as long as you, as a runner, aren't.
Upset. Yeah, exactly. Not a big deal. Oh, wait, no, that's not the same alert I have, actually. Go, so sorry. I have the orange Jinjo. Unless he has a different one for raids and stuff. Censor what? Oh, he's gonna go. Oh, he tried. He tried to go for the quick boombox skip. Censor Falcon, to be honest, pretty much. Nerd.
I mean, I believe in free speech.
Oh, can't even get in this window. Yep, now he's out of. Now he's going to freeze easy peak. He's going to the cold.
We just barely missing that peck onto the ladder, taking a dip into the oily water.
Yeah, if not dying in engine room, Pixel has a pretty good chance, like pretty good lead. Because like I was like kind of one of the, unless he falls a lot of times in Click Clack Wood, because a bunch of stuff can happen there too.
Yeah.
Could die in winter.
Like seriously though, this is like good PB pace, like for him. for like 239. Like, this is pretty good.
Yeah, this isn't bad at all, despite like the miss, like remembering the route before going. But yeah,
I mean, yeah, that was like honestly like 45 seconds maybe.
But that's
like, not
yeah.
even a minute. Yeah.
Yeah, it's not even that bad. I like how the game looks without filters. Yeah.
I do agree.
Same. Oh!
So easy with some interesting strats here. It's... Pebble's getting the chair bounce.
That's pretty unlucky. I haven't gotten the chair bounce in forever, actually.
Maybe we'll have to predict on like some file slide.
Yeah, that's a good idea. We can do that next time.
I don't know what the odds are on that. But...
Yeah, I have no clue either. What the percentage would be. Demonoid? Is anyone else's audio super quiet? Yeah, can you guys hear me clearly? I should be able to.
It's probably quiet compared to other streams that you're listening to.
I mean, I do have the game audio pretty like loud. Maybe I could turn that down a bit.
No, it's mostly just overall, I think.
Yeah. The mics could be turned up a bit. Okay. Maybe, I got an idea. I'll turn up the desktop audio, but I'll turn down the game audio.
I think you just have to turn everything up.
Like a little. That? How's that sound, guys? Just yell everything schlong like. Yeah. Yeah, I could.
I'm hearing like pretty minimal game volume.
Okay. Should be fine now.
If we've dealt with it this long.
Yeah. Oh, maybe my mic too. So I think I have to do that too. You may have known that. Let me know if that helps a bit.
It's not too bad. Like, I can hear game audio and I can hear us.
Oh, are you on the stream basically? You're hearing it?
Yeah, I was listening.
Okay, yeah. Sweet. Then we Gucci.
Yeah, it's alright.
How much health Pimble's he
is? Waiting completely till there's
Twinkies. Maybe you went to the restroom or something.
You know, that's a reasonable time to go to the bathroom, for sure.
I think I've done that before. And I'm just like, and then I get hit by the snowball. I'm like, no! Yo, what's up, Clinette?
Clinette in the house.
Yippee, be a star and you'll find your reward.
I thought, man, whenever you're in this room and you see the two grublins next to each other, like, if you get hit, your console can soft lock.
That's happened to me, actually, during practice.
Oh, yeah?
I was like, no! So I always get, like, a slight, like, I get, like, super, a little bit anxiety just, like, seeing them go together. So I try to separate them every time now.
Yeah, you don't see it too often, but it's nice, you know. We saw Pixweezy just taking them both out there. But, so.
It's because they tried to do the fusion dance. That's what happened. That's why it crashes.
Pebble's pausing?
Looks like maybe, yeah, or maybe something happened.
Yeah, sometimes you just gotta pause, take a deep breath.
Yeah.
This game can get a little stressful sometimes, not gonna lie. Oh, okay. Kiss it.
That's honestly like the best thing about speedrunning. You can just pause.
Yeah, exactly. Oh wait, he's missing a note somewhere. Oh no, never mind. I thought he already got four notes and it was gonna be 99. Never mind.
Man, during my last BK League race, I had 99 notes out of Respect Bay. I got raided by Duck, and I just forgot to grab the last note in this room.
Oh no, that's like.
And then super... I just finished, and I was like, oops, I gotta get all 100 again.
I gotta get all, yeah. Is it, oh, that's why you had like a lot more time on the time or whatever. You
yeah,
could... Okay. Like, oh, hello everybody. I missed a note.
Just one note. If only I was playing on Xbox.
Yeah, exactly. It's what all you have to do is go and like split after you get 100 notes. Did you find out after Grunty or like right before the note door?
Yeah, right before the note door, yeah.
Oh, damn. Yo, what's up, Aquamarines? They're not just Marines, they're Aquamarines. Water Marines. Oh, Pembles just said boo. Did something happen?
I don't know.
Hopefully his console didn't... Oh, but it froze or something.
General disdain, perhaps.
Yeah.
I don't know when... He found a spot.
Yeah, dude.
Say it.
Yo, Pembles is an expert, dude. Finds all those time saves. Alright, and he's basically finished. All he has to do is beak bust after this honeycomb. Nice. Still no washi. So we got we got three more chances. Chup's like, oh damn, but he's actually secretly happy. Oh damn, in his mind, yes, 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 no washi.
The perfect time for like an ask me one evil.
There's one chance. Let's see if it is.
Yeah, Pembles.
Washi. Oh yeah, he's gotta get the notes. Oh, Pembles stopping for a second.
Taking a deep breath. Aligning the chakrams.
No washi!
Yeah, no washi here. Still got two more chances.
Two more chances. What did you vote for? Did you vote for no washi?
I initiated the ball, so I cannot vote.
Oh, damn, okay. Oh, was he going for Kentucky Chiefs? Brad is the chicken for you, man.
Pembles is picking up four notes there. So when you're Walrus and you're making your way towards the bog race, you want to pick up three notes and then make your way to the honeycomb. It's just simply more optimal.
Yeah. Yeah, I know we were in call. I forgot who he's going for. I thought he's going for... I don't even know. I didn't even hear him mention it. Oh. Oh, he got the jump. Nice.
Yeah, got the jump.
Pebbles do the leg strat?
It's so fun. So that jump, honestly, only came about in like 2019. Oh, wait, what's he doing?
Oh, damn, he can't do the leg strat.
Okay.
Oh. Get the note. It came about when? Sorry.
So, yeah, so that jump strat, like, so that jump strat didn't exist for the longest time. Like, you know, Stiv for the longest time was just doing the right leg strat.
Without the thing, without the...
Yeah, without the jump, and it was just incredibly tight. But, like, that jump came about, and then it was...
Found it.
So, like, picking the jiggy up in, like, the lobby, like, the eye jiggy, picking that up as the B, that only came out, after, like, SGDQ 2019.
Hmm.
And it was, like, a really small finding.
Gotcha.
Oh. Like, one of the cool things is, the original practice ROM, it doesn't have any compensation for the eye jiggy.
Pebbles lost the race, and the exact same thing happened with Wheezy. They both did the same thing. I know it's nothing.
That's true.
About.
Yeah.
I know nothing about, but bear that protect attack. But most importantly, he turns into B Mario. But I want to say good luck to them. Yo, thank you, Aquamarines. Yep, lost. They both went to left side. That's what you got. Yeah, I'm saying you gotta let Boggy go ahead of you. Okay, he's making that a little bit easier. Interesting. Oh, he's under. Get out of the bridge.
Get out of there.
Oh no.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, I was watching on the stream. I was a little bit bored, but
yeah, I was like, oh. And we're east cruising in spring. Soon to be cruising in summer.
Cruising through summer.
Cruising through spring. Little Eerie.
Mama.
Shoutouts to Oxy. Alright, Pixel taking a little safe here.
Yeah, that's super safe.
Yeah.
You can recoil off the nest and like end up down by those nodes.
Mm-hmm.
Honestly, like, seriously, like, Banjo-Kazooie is honestly just, like, if you can keep your head in the game and you cannot die, like, you'll have a decent run.
Does Polly sound
like...
That's
what he's doing.
Yeah. They're saying you sound like PG. I can kind of see it.
So, here's my story about PG. When I was in middle school, I had an iPod Classic. That might date it. But I downloaded PG's speedruns for Banjo-Tooie. And I converted them to MP4 so I could put them on my iPod Classic so I can watch them during Stony Hall in middle school.
That's pretty cool. I didn't know. Man, he's been speedrunning for a while, huh? Like,
yeah, PG and Stiv have always been the Banjo dudes.
Okay. Pretty cool. What was in Softlock? Oh, yeah, I don't think he's going for Softlock. Or maybe? At least I didn't see him do it. Oh, he does do soft lock. Okay, never mind. Wrong.
Yeah, I saw him get hit by the bees. I wasn't sure if that was just a swag thing or if he was actually going for the soft lock.
Swag! Why does he do soft lock? I mean, it is faster, and if you practice it, why not? been practicing, you might go, oh shoot, okay. We're gonna see our first softlock. Actually, I don't think we saw Eagle do it, so this is gonna be our first softlock of the novice tournament. It is pretty cool though. He definitely doesn't need it, but it's a real cool trick. I should relearn it again and keep trying for that sub 210.
Same. I never learned soft lock, but I know I need to use it. Mm-hmm. I want to learn MMM early.
Yeah, I want to, but I was trying. I mean, I've got it before, but it's so tough, because I'll accidentally, hold, diagonal a little bit, and it'll make me look up, and I'm like, no, I didn't mean to do that.
Yeah. I was cautious about doing FP early in a run, and I've honestly just recently come around to be like, I can probably do FP early. But only because, I only have to do FP early once now. Because MMM early exists.
Yeah.
So it's kind of funny. But...
Exactly. MMM early, I think if you grinded practice, a lot of people have learned it already, so I don't think it'd be that hard to learn.
Yeah, it doesn't seem too bad. It's like you gotta do, you just gotta find the spot, and then you gotta pause, find the spot, do the thing.
Yeah, exactly. Pause.
You just gotta completely internalize that and do it 100 times.
Yeah.
And then you can do it in runs.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Hag started learning MMM early recently, actually. Pixel Wheezy. Freaking frozen through summer.
Dude, he's going for the crazy strat. Look at him. He's gonna roll. Oh, okay.
Okay, yeah, I thought he was gonna roll too. I was gonna be like, oh damn. I was about to be amazed if he did that.
Oh yeah.
What's up, Silver Ortle? Yeah, what Tyson said, you can't break the boulder until summer. Wait, what? You can poop an egg onto the boulder and break it? That's not how physics work.
Eggs can't break boulders.
You actually can. I can confirm this. If you're in a very specific position, you can break the boulder.
Dude, I wanna test that. Yo, these novice races be giving making us find new strats. It's a little egg.
No, I'm pretty sure Tyson. I don't know if I saw it in the TAS, but I'm almost positive that an egg can break the rock.
I'm just dying. Chep's saying, yeah, you could swim inside and it's really weird. You just swim in there in spring, and you just see the beaver like munching on Doritos, and he looks behind him. He's like, it's not what it looks like. This is doing something weird.
Trep is scarred forever.
Oh shoot, yep. It'll be engine room soon. Four pembles. Not what it looks like. I'm not eating chips, I promise.
Look, these Fritos are simply fire starters.
I just visualized that in my head. I'm crazy. Yeah. Yeah, that's funny.
That's what I just thought of that when Trev said that. It's like, dude, he's like, do not swim to Naughty's house in spring. It's weird, man. Okay. Usually I go for the note right after the first bird in fall, and then I go back after he's done pecking. Is that what you do, Polly?
Just say it again, I'm sorry.
After the first bird, when I go up the hill, I get the note under it, and I also, get the note after, and then come back after he's done pecking.
Yeah. With the birds and fall, yeah.
Yeah,
definitely
just
you can
manipulate that a little bit. Easy. Oh, that looks like Pembles won. Hell yeah. Oh yeah. Easy. Oh.
You had to put that easy real quick.
Super easy.
I think Pembles can actually PB, I think, still. Possibly. Theoretically.
So what, he's got to do Rusty Bucket Bay and Click Clack Woods?
Yeah, but he doesn't have to do RBA. So it's like,
right.
Let's see. I think. Oh, but he does have to get these two jiggies. So I can't really tell. Be pretty
I
close.
Believe in him.
Yeah, I think he could do it.
Unless he like misses this jump here. Is this
Oh, he made it! What? He slid on the crystal into the Wait, did he just do a quick dive like that? What? Pembles, you're a madman! How many strats does Pembles know that we don't know?
It wasn't exactly a quick dive, but it was definitely like
definitely pretty crazy though. Yeah. I don't think. Yeah, maybe it wasn't. It's crazy. Pembles, teach us, dude. Master Pembles.
Super swag for sure.
Dude, for real. Swag strat. Okay, he's getting that Momo token.
Squeezy falling down there.
Yep. Yeah, maybe that is what he said easy to.
Alright. Pembles going with the strat. So he's gonna be double backing here. You know, you can choose to get the eye jiggy with your feet and like kind of fly out of there.
Yeah.
But it looks like Pembles is just kind of going for this jiggy here. He's gonna try and peak bomb it as soon as he can get aligned, and then he's gonna fly back out and get the eye jiggy and not really have any concerns. A little high there.
Oh, here we go. But
yeah, this should be good hit. Yeah. Back out and get the eye jiggy.
I remember Shakes had a run where he like beak bombed into the calendar jiggy, and like he biffed it and like went into the FP level.
Oh, into FP?
Yeah, so like he hit the bottom of it, and then like he did like a little thing where it rolled him onto the ground into the level, and I was like, what?
Yeah, I've seen the tumble. I haven't seen tumble into FP though. That's pretty funny.
Yeah, it was great. But that clip's still around. Tree troubles again. All right, Pembles versus Engine Room. Who will win? Oh.
Nice little hop there.
Yeah.
That jump doesn't save too much time, but it's a good little optimization.
Oh yeah, because like, because without that strat, you just go around the boxes, right?
Yeah, I think you're supposed to, like, climb up the stairway there and then just kind of walk around and
yeah,
get the ding pot and jump over from those boxes.
Yep.
But you can just kind of hop off the pole there.
Oh, it's getting on lunchtime. I wonder what I'm going to eat for lunch.
Today for the Super Bowl, I delivered one order. It was like a couple pizzas and some wangs.
Oh,
and
nice.
And another order was like a whole turkey dinner.
Oh, damn. What would you go for, Prof? Would you go for the turkey dinner or would you go for the pizzas and wings?
Honestly, the turkey dinner.
Turkey sounds good, but the grease sounds pretty good. The wings. I don't know why.
Definitely for like the party situation, pizza is superior for sure.
PBs aren't everything. Yeah. I mean, kind of mostly.
True, I mean, it's a tournament, so it's about.
Oh, yeah, definitely. In a tournament setting, yeah. PBs definitely aren't everything. Definitely appreciated, but I guess like during a run, kind of matter about improving as well, so. I usually kind of focus on getting golds too, or like getting close to my gold as possible. That's what I try to improve on mostly. Those, I think that's what really matters.
I haven't seen Pixelweezy run before, but they've definitely had some really good movement throughout, and I'm pretty impressed.
Yeah, same. Emble's taking a safe again with this pipe strat. Ensure the pipe stop before he crosses. Your golds are bad, Tyson. Same. I'm under a minute, though, of each split compared to... What's his name? He does RRBA. He's the best RRBA. Forgot his name. Oh, it's gonna kill me. Wait, let me find out my notes. Youngster Joey, that's what it is. Yeah, Joey. Yeah. Each split, I made sure I'm under a minute of each of his splits, so. I think sub 50 seconds actually now. Yeah, dude. Pebble's fucking like strats there is awesome. The beak bust into it. Have you ever heard of that strat, Asmi? Where he just beak busts, like, easily. Well, not easily, but lines himself up.
Wait, he's beak busting through the strats here?
Yeah, watch this. Yep, he's gonna do it. Oh! Yeah. Oh, it's so sweaty! It's hard to do, actually. Yeah, it kind of does look hard.
I saw my boy Mumbo Italiano. He introduced me to the beak bomb, or the ground pound through.
Oh, the ground pound through. Yeah. Yeah. It's pretty epic. Oh, but he's having trouble clipping through this window. All right, he's resetting.
Mumboy. Yeah, shout out to the boy Mumboy Italiano.
Mumbo. Oh, Italiano. Not sure I knew who that is.
He didn't stream too much. I don't really know.
Guy did a little wiggle method.
He did some good Emmy runs.
Oh yeah, Emmy is a little hard to do. Do it though, I know he can. There we go, nice. Mumboy. Oh, I don't know if he's gonna get this jiggy. It's gonna be tough though, with Eagle or Aerie.
Yeah, it's kind of a pretty low Jiggy. I think he's got it. I believe.
Oh, yep. Wait. Oh, he got it!
Yeah.
Nice. I've never seen anyone go that low to get it, though, before. It's always usually high for me.
Yeah, if you can conserve feathers trying to get it, like, that's the biggest thing.
Boo bears!
My wife said boo-boo bears.
Pixwheezy has, like, some, like, really good strats. I'm excited to see what time he finishes with here.
Wait, I'll be right back, guys.
Alright. Yo. This is your chance. If you've got a better Twitch TV and you see Mum Bone Zone, just get a little Mum Bone Zone in the chat. It's really good. And it's visually stunning. It's been created by Lane and Lurks, and just post it. That's all you need. Look at all these Banjo-Kazooie related emotes. I'm not. Look, Garlic posted Mumbone Zone, Tyson posted Mumbone Zone. I decided to post a Mumbone Zone myself, and just seemed like a thing to do. Just throwing it out there. You don't have to. Saying. What's better Twitch TV? Well, if you Google better Twitch TV, you can install an add-on to your browser, and you can see animated emotes as well as some other non-animated emotes.
Ooh, Sugoi.
Sugoi?
Sugoi, man. And he's in spring. About to end off clock wood here. All that's left after this is RRBA, Furtisphone, and Grunty. For Pixel, at least.
Yeah.
Oh, baby, we're gonna see some softlock action.
You know, I wouldn't think that we would see softlock in the novice tournament, but here we are. Definitely gives me high hopes for Pixelweezy down the road.
Yeah, definitely.
Look at this. He's a master.
Yeah, he's got this. Tyson, you should totally do softlock. Do it, dude. Wait, can you do softlock on Xbox?
So? I don't see why you wouldn't be able to.
True. X, bro.
Look X at him. Pixelweezy's in there.
Oh!
He didn't even struggle. He didn't need to do the backup.
Dude, Pixel, yo, did that like a champ. He did that better than me. Sorry, I guess I screamed too loud there. I got excited. Damn. Okay. Oh, I didn't
All right,
get...
So it's looking kind of bad. For washing machine T-Rex believers.
No. I just want my points. I got one last chance. Pembles, I'm counting on you. Actually, we might not even get that if Pixel continues on this pace. Because then we'll ask Pembles if he wants to keep continuing. If Pixel wins early before he transforms.
We'll see.
I don't know why he didn't get the Jiggy first, or maybe he forgot it.
Yeah, it looks like it was forgotten.
This could be a new PB. Let's see if it hits a red here.
Yeah, I mean, Pixelweezy's definitely on PB pace here.
Yep. Oh, he's out. Let's see where he's at right now.
Oh, I love you. Open the door.
Please never make that sound again. What sound?
This one. Do it.
Was that what you were talking about, Tyson? They said they can hear you. Say hi. Very high-pitched voice. Alright, so this is a clean RRBA so far.
Seeing that little bee booty.
Yeah.
Through those grates.
Nice. Hit the wall there, but it's fine.
I don't think you can do that room without hitting that wall there. I'm not
I have before.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, you gotta like hit barely above the ledge and then you'll make it in clean.
Oh.
Oh shoot. No, we got IJL! No!
IJL. Oh gosh. Alright, this is Pebble's chance.
This is Pebble's chance to catch up. Oh, he's going. Dude,
yeah,
I would have.
He went for boat jump there.
Dude, that would have been the craziest thing ever if he got it.
I need to just do boat jump a billion times, honestly.
Yeah, that's how I practice. Or I just need to make sure I get it a lot of times before I do it. I think I got it once or twice in one of my novice tournament races. I think it was against GDO.
There you go.
Wait, DD got stuck in IGL for 30 minutes. Oh, man, that sucks. Oh, wow, I've never seen anyone hit that bomb with a P before. That's unlucky. Blame the RNG gods. Little low. Oh, there we go. He ain't lost. You did boat jump in your first run because you knew that the run was going to be shit anyway and I wanted to try. Did you get it, Snoopy? Or did you... Oh...
I definitely support it in like your first run, like going for all the strats that you want to.
Yeah,
you got
exactly.
Nothing to compare it against.
Yeah, you got nothing to lose. Might as well.
Two tries. Yeah, not bad.
Took me a million tries my first time. Ooh-y, I'm
so conflicted, Schlongster. I want to do. Any percent no DCW / BC.
Oh, like no big clips, basically, and all that?
Yeah, because there's been some recent developments about the TDL route.
Oh, yeah, I saw that. Alaris posted it. It was, like, PG demonstrating it, and it looked kind of fun, honestly.
Yeah, right? Like, it's a good category.
Mm-hmm.
I enjoy the restrictions, and... You know, it seems like a good optimization.
That stuff might come to 100%. Oh, okay.
What?
Oh, dude. Oh my gosh, that's pretty cool. I mean, I plan on doing no DCW anyway, cause like the 301. I want to do like a multiple rareware game with any percent restrictions. So that'd be pretty fun. Doing a no RBA and then no DCW and then no levels early for Donkey Kong.
I just want to see some Diddy Kong Racing representation on the multiple rare games category.
Well, Slipboy, I could definitely learn that before 6 months. If it takes me 6 months to learn those categories, I got a problem.
Honestly, Shalong, at the end of the day, you're gonna have time if you're like staying at home with your kid.
Oh yeah, true. Crosby has time, and he has like two kids. Right, prof.
True, Pixel Weezy did get a picture question here. He is making his way to the second death square.
Oh, you gonna try it? He's got it, he can do it.
It's definitely harder on the second one here.
Dude, I remember when Phantasma, it was Phantasma versus Dozium, and like, it was crazy. Oh, okay, you got it. Oh, wait, did he get it? Or did he accidentally hit Yay?
Extra wife.
Pixel wants an extra wife. Type 1. JK. But yeah, I remember their Dozium and Phantasma were like on Furnace Fun, and like, she was having a tough time getting the picture question on the second one. That one's like a little tough. More tough than the first one. Actually, yeah, I disagree. Second one, it feels a little bit easier than this first one, honestly, because all you have to push is a little bit right, and you'll be lined up. Yeah, that's true, Tice. I'll be on a big banjo break, but I'll still be supporting the community.
That's what it's all about, baby.
Supporting the community. Right. I'll root for you
if
guys.
You can be there and you can, like, you can help somebody set up FFM. Like, that's...
Yeah.
That's what it's all about, baby.
Plus, it'd be nice to have a little break, too. Like, I love writing banjo, but it'd be cool just to help people. I like helping people anyway, so...
You gotta post a 200% time, and then you can stop.
Dude, he's gonna PB by, like, 4 minutes.
That's what I, right? Like, Pixelweezy's got it. He's crushing.
No, you don't, slip boy. You yell at me all the time. Oh, yeah, dude. We should make tournament races for BK, like a league race.
Like, if we.
When have I ever been well behaved, slip boy? I've never done a league race. Buddy, that's gonna change, dude. You're gonna join the next league race. It'd honestly help you, like, complete a run, too, Footy. Like, you don't know resets. I think that's what you need, too.
Yeah, I mean, honestly, like, the... So, I've been doing the BK League, like, since it started this year. And in my most recent run, I golded Grunty. And I don't think I would have done it if I wasn't doing BK League races.
Yeah.
Like, it's just kind of rewarding to just get out there and just...
You got a sub 220, right? Like, you got close to your PB, right, Foot or Prof?
My BK League time wasn't super good. It's like a 224.55.
Still honestly pretty good, despite, like, how long it's been since you last, like, really grinded for BK, you know?
Yeah. So. It's not terrible, you know. I'm hoping to get my improvement times, get some improvement points.
Yeah, but Footy, like, also that feeling, like, of, like... Because, like, the feeling of that you need, like, or the mentality of you that you know that you're racing someone also helps, too. Because you know you're racing is another factor that play into it.
I've honestly always been pretty good about just, like, well, I'm in a race. I just can't quit.
Yeah, exactly.
I always just, like, get up immediately. Do what I gotta do.
Exactly. Because you're a little bit more competitive once you know that you're racing someone, too. If you're not competitive, why are you racing? Not gonna lie, races don't really change how I conduct. Oh, they don't? Oh. That's fair. It really changed me. I gotta play, like, I don't know what it is. It shouldn't honestly happen. I should play the same no matter what. But when I know I'm racing someone, like, I try, like, maximum. Like, I go above 100%. If that makes sense. I stay really focused. Also, it helps because, like, tournament races, you're muted, so you don't get to talk to your chat. Just focused on the game. Go Ultra Instinct. Yeah. Oh, you are? Oh, yeah, because the Bucks won. The Pirates the Pirates won, Aaron.
We got some salty bets going on.
Yeah. BK hundo grinding. Okay, I like that, Aaron. So after Tui hundo, you're going to do some the tournament. You're going to do... I'll grind with you, Aaron. I need to get back into BK. But I really want that sub 5 in Tui.
You can focus on Tui and, you know, BK will come natural.
Hell yeah. And
look at this, Pixel Weezy's gonna get a new PB. Oh, it's you die. Oh. I believe in him. He's got this right here. Look at this.
PB!
Wow!
And a 236.10. Congratulations, PXL Weezy. Or, hell, Pixel Weezy. PXL. Alright, should one of us go to Pemble's channel and ask if he wants to keep going, or?
I think we should probably.
Oh, wait, I think he knows. Wait,
okay, yeah, this guy, so it looks like he knows. I don't know. I, like, you know, it's up to him.
Yeah.
If he wants to.
Yeah, I can go ask him real quick, if you want me to.
We could drag him in.
Oh, yeah. I'll do that. Yo, congratulations, Pixel!
Hey, thank you so much. Oh my god.
Hell yeah, dude. How do you feel right now? Oh, I need to drag Pembles in.
Hold on, let me.
Yo, congratulations, Pixel!
Turn myself up on my stream.
Okay. I could hear myself. Hell yeah, dude. How do you feel right now? Oh, I need to drag Pembles in.
No, I'm good. Hi, chat.
We did it.
Oh man, I'm shaking, man. Oh my gosh.
I told you would. Like I said, I'm good luck chucking races. People PB when I race against them. I don't know why. Probably because I'm racing him.
Okay, hopefully I can't hear myself anymore. I turned it down. Oh.
Well, GG Pembles. That was, man, there was some mess ups that I did in that like really, really was scaring me. Like, Freeze Easy, I had that shave on with as the walrus. I had that. And then all of a sudden, like, I don't know what happened, but Baki was just all like, it wouldn't let me go through the last slalom. And I would have had that. If I didn't lose that shave, man, I would have had it. I would have had a better PB.
It happened to me too.
Really? Yeah. It sucks because I started to manage to get my time up. I started managing to get my time up. Then there were certain things that did scare me. Like, the one thing that, like, everything else was fine up until I got to Rusty Bucket. When I got to Rusty Bucket, that's when things gotten really scary because I did the fans. And after I did the fans, I couldn't clip through the window.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
Why am I not clipping? Why am I not clipping through the window? I'm like, come on. So I was like, right when I got through, I'm like, okay, I've only got like 30 seconds. I have to get the jiggy. If I don't get the jiggy, it's screwed.
Like, yeah.
I have to get it. So I had to reroute just a tiny bit, but it lost me some time. And then before I got to Rusty Bucket, I was all like, my mind just turned off. And I was like, yeah, I got to go get Mumbo's Mad Monster. And I was like, crap! I got to turn around!
Yeah, man, you fucking handled that ending like a champ, man. It was pretty dope.
Thank you, guys. I thought I almost didn't get the soft lock because I was like, why am I not in yet? I should be in. And then I was like, I keep going, and then I got in. I'm like, what the hell?
That soft lock was so dope. Like, I screamed after you got it, and people were like, Schlongster stuff. I was like, ah!
Out of my Schlongster. That swag strat was totally intended.
Wait, you're talking
head.
Oh, are you talking about the FP one?
Yes.
That was so dope. So what Pebbles did, Pixel, is he jumped onto the crystal. You know when you at the end where you dive into the water and you go into the hole to end FP?
Yes.
He like went on the crystal on the right and then slid onto left and like dove into he dove into it. It was pretty dope.
Really?
It was a complete fluke.
Yeah.
Wow, that's really cool.
Yeah.
That's really cool. That's a different really interesting way to do it.
I'm thinking of putting it onto handing it into Glad Jonas if that's all right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sure.
I mean, if there's new things that that get discovered like that, I mean, you know, I there's people in my chat that tell me I should do the fourth hut jump. Oh, that was the other thing.
Oh yeah, I was like, is he gonna go for another hut jump? Is he gonna go for a third hut jump?
Oh god. Well, like, so hut jumps are kind of like it's like TTC for me, because the chest for TTC is like the worst. And then the next thing after that is the huts. But there's someone in my chat usually tells me I should get the hut before I can jump from the hut before getting to the red-eyed crocodile. And I know it's possible, but it's so much more riskier. And I'm like, no, I'm just going to break the hut and go for it. But that was another thing I could have done to save time. But I know it's not used traditionally in the runs, at least I don't think. So,
yeah, I think he lost about like 40 seconds to a minute from like missing those hut jumps. So it's a big time save right there.
Yeah, I'm looking at my PB, you know, 236.10. You know, I am super happy with that. It's a 3-minute PB. But, you know, let's see. Let's see what happens when we save those splits. Well, hold on. How do I do? Oh, right.
Look,
there you go. Save.
I knew that 227? The fact that I'm on sub 330 pace at the moment, I won't finish, but I'm going to get as far as I can before I got to go.
Yeah. All right, let's look at the brackets right now. Let's see. Pixel, you'll be going against the loser of Eric's and Eagle Danger. So that's that. And
you know who?
Yeah, what's up?
Go ahead.
Oh,
no, go ahead.
I was about to say, Pembles, you are out of the tournament, but yeah, you played really good, man. Like, after like a long time of like just being on break for BK, like, you actually played really well. I was impressed.
GG, man. That's GG, man. What was your PB?
2 hours and 52 minutes and 49 seconds.
Mm-hmm. Well, you're on course to doing a sub 240. Are you on track to doing a sub 240 or is it sub 230?
Oh, well, no, he's on he's not on track to PB, I don't think.
Oh, okay.
No, I'm not on track to PB. I'm on the Clockwood.
Yeah.
Oh, I see.
But it's still.
That's still really cool.
It's pretty good. This is my second run from a 6-month break.
I'll tell you what. If I like took a break for 6 months, I would probably it'd probably be like 3+ hours. It'd be pretty bad.
Yeah, I'm probably still. Like, I might do some runs in the. In the Banjo League, maybe next time.
Oh, heck yeah, that'd be awesome, Pembles. You gotta join it, man. It'd be fun to have you.
Yeah, not the one that's in April, I'm gonna join.
Okay, epic.
I've got to practice.
Yeah, practice makes perfect.
Although I'm pretty happy with how I've adapted to it.
Yeah, man. You did fun. Thank you for joining the tournament too.
Thanks for having me.
Of course.
Alrighty, guys. I'm gonna take off. Thank you guys so much for having me.
Dude, no problem. And congratulations on the win, man.
Thank you.
Yeah, congrats on the win. And extra congrats on the PB.
Thank you guys so much. Alrighty, guys. I'll talk to you later.
Alright.